Good morning, and thank you for joining us for this special edition of the Eyewitness Morning News on this Wednesday, October 28th. I'm Sheba Turk.
And I'm Leslie Spinn, and we will be tracking Hurricane Zeta for you all day. It is expected to make landfall in southeast Louisiana and impact everyone in our viewing area.
So we want to turn straight to some information you need to know about Zeta. We actually just got that 4 a.m. update. We can expect landfall sometime later this afternoon. But it could strengthen before it gets to us. So let's get straight over to local weather expert Dave Nussbaum for the latest on Zeta. Oh, actually, we'll get to that in just a moment. Sorry, Dave. If you live in the city of New Orleans and you haven't done so already, you can move your car to the neutral grounds to keep them safe from high water. Parking restrictions were lifted last night at 6 p.m. And remember not to block streetcar tracks, intersections, or sidewalks. Remember to bring in any signs or other hazards from the neutral grounds or yards so that they don't blow around in Zeta's winds. And plenty of evacuations are or will be in place later this morning. The areas include parts of Jefferson, Plaquemines, Orleans, and Terrebonne parishes. For specifics on those evacuation orders, you can head over to WWLTV.com where we have a full list. You can also stay up to date with Zeta by texting 504-529-4444. You can text the word app to download the WWLTV app or the word storm for Zeta updates. You can also send us photos or videos of the storm. Just include your name and the location and time along with the image. Now let's get over to Dave for the latest on Zeta. I know we just got that updated, Dave.
Yeah, winds up to 85 miles per hour now, moving north-northwest at 17. So starting to make that northerly turn. It's not a very large hurricane, but you can see there's a well-defined eye showing up here with it on the satellite, and the pressure's down to 982, about 320 miles south-southwest of the mouth of the Mississippi River. You can see here on water vapor showing where the storm is. There's that trough. That's what's helping to pull it north, and there is some wind shear with it, but Zeta's moving pretty quick. It may actually not even be impacted by that wind shear now, and that is going to change things drastically for us. We emphasized the last couple days that wind is going to be an issue. I think now it's going to be a real significant issue for us as we move forward throughout the day. Now, we do have some bands of rain coming through now. We'll see a few more bands by lunchtime along the coastline, and then more of that move inland across the area as we head throughout the afternoon hours. Landfall is now expected this afternoon down along the coast. And you can see here, we look at this expected now to be a category one, or staying that way, but a category two hurricane now with winds of 100 miles per hour. So this is going to be a significant wind storm for us as we head throughout the afternoon hours here today. So landfall is expected this afternoon here. I stopped it by 7 o'clock. It's already north of Slidell here near, say, Pearl River area and back toward Picayune, Mississippi. So landfall here across southeast Louisiana, likely the eye could be moving right over the city with 100 mile per hour winds now. That's a category two on the Saffir-Simpson scale. So we're talking about significant wind damage and widespread power outages expected with this one. It'll be moving very fast, so the wind won't last for very long, only a couple of hours, but still going to be doing significant damage potentially across the area here. Now, strongest winds may be just off to the east of the city, which is good because that would be on the right side. That's usually where they're located. So that would be good for the city. But those areas that are in that air zone, obviously things would be looking pretty rough. So I am expecting 100 mile per hour winds, especially down along the coastal areas for the day today's. And that's also going to likely change. We'll have to get the new surge numbers, but they may come up just a little bit as well, too. Again, storm is moving very fast, so that's at least some good news. You'll see here by 1 a.m. it's already not too far from Tuscaloosa on Thursday morning. By 1 o'clock Thursday afternoon, it's already up near, central part of Virginia. So this storm is moving very, very fast indeed. So hurricane warnings are still obviously in effect for our area as we go forward throughout the day today. And you can see there's spaghetti model plots all in agreement here, southeast Louisiana. Nothing has really changed at all with that as it continues to ride here on that western edge of that ridge of high pressure. And you can see as the storm moves to the north, gets absorbed into that trough or that low. The only good thing about all this is that tomorrow behind the storm, as we clean up, we are going to be dealing with again definitely some much cooler weather. Now, this was as of earlier. I need to update these numbers here as the new numbers have just come in. But we're talking 70 to 100 mile per hour winds, at least in the yellow, white here. In the bluer shade, we're talking at least 60 to 70 here, maybe stronger than that. Wouldn't be surprised if closer to 60 to 80 mile per hour winds. Then as you go to the west, they quickly decrease. So the strongest winds, by all means, are going to be across the north shore, south shore here, coastal areas, and coastal Mississippi area, dealing with those strongest winds as we get throughout this afternoon into this evening. And by overnight, overnight tonight, the winds will die down. So we are going to see a daytime landfall here, something we don't see very often lately. It's always been kind of in the overnight hours or early morning, but definitely be prepared for that as we go forward here on into the afternoon and into the evening hours today. You can see here, take a look at this. This is one of the models here. By lunchtime today, 12, 14, 30 mile per hour winds, not too bad here. But look at this, wind gusts at 109 miles per hour down in Port Fouchon. That is at 4 o'clock this afternoon as landfall is occurring there. As we head to the evening, you saw there 80 mile per hour wind gusts across the metro area here. By 8 o'clock this evening, the storm is up near the Slidell area where winds are gusting to over 70 miles per hour. And then this is going to race to the north. So by midnight, our winds are dying down already. And then into tomorrow morning, we're looking at light winds. Great weather out there by 7 a.m. So I am expecting much stronger winds. I wouldn't be surprised if we see some wind gusts about 110 you just saw there down to the Port Fouchon Grand Isle area. So things are definitely going to be a little bit different there. Latest surge numbers here, we'll get the new ones coming in, but at least at this point, 2 to 4 in the lakes, 4 to 6 from really about, say, Port Fouchon area all the way to the mouth of the Pearl River, from the Pearl River all the way over. The updates there continue to be here we go. They're new ones, 6 to 9. Is what we're looking at there. So here the new ones are updated. So 3 to 5 feet here across Lake Pontchartrain now. We're looking at 5 to 7 now from Port Fouchon area all the way to the mouth of the Pearl River. And then from the mouth of the Pearl River all the way to about Dauphin Island, 6 to 9 foot storm surge. Now that's pretty significant along the Mississippi coast. The reason why they're higher, this storm is expected to be stronger now. So this is kind of what we're looking at with a fast moving storm coming on in. So that was the new numbers there. Peyton just kind of showed you there with the new updates. Rain total still about the same, 2 to 4 inches across the area, 3 to 5 as you head into Mississippi. And quickly as you go to the west, we'll see a quick drop down of rain once you go west of I-55. Not expecting quite as much out across those areas there. So PrecisionCast does show again some little rain by 7 o'clock this morning. And then you see there the storm making landfall about 4 o'clock this afternoon down here along the coastline roughly. And there's your strong storm starting to come in by 3 or 4 o'clock. We'll feel them here and they're continuing on to the evening hours. By 7 o'clock, the storm again centered about your Slidell. That's where I will be. So it is going to move right over the city. Your strongest heavy rain and winds kind of working its way there to the north there and to the Mississippi coast, feeling this as well. Again, west of I-55, probably won't feel much of anything at that point from the Hammond area back over toward Baton Rouge. And as we go to tomorrow morning, you'll see by, or rather 10 o'clock tonight, the rain's kind of tapering off by 11:30. How about tomorrow morning? The sun is out. We're actually having great weather out there throughout Thursday, and it continues into Thursday afternoon as well. So definitely things will be going downhill starting about lunchtime today along the coastline and about, say, early mid afternoon here across the metro area as well as we're getting ready for a Category 2 hurricane. I'll have more details and all that coming up here in just a little bit. And let's go over to Sheba.
Yeah, so Dave, you kind of gave us the timeline of where we'll be seeing these impacts. Let's focus again on the city. If people are going to work and school today, when should they kind of be plan to be where they're going to be to ride this storm out?
Once we get to midday today, you need to be at home again, especially starting down along the coastline and then working its way north into the city as well, too, because things will be starting to go downhill. We really won't feel the strongest winds until maybe about, say, 4 o'clock here, to about, say, 7 o'clock in the city, including in the North Shore as well. But again, we're talking a Category 2 hurricane now, Sheba. So this is going to be a big difference. We're talking winds, potentially landfall, 100 miles per hour.
Wow.
Wind gusts easily at 80 miles per hour here. And one comparison people have made is back to 2005 Hurricane Cindy, the kind of forgotten hurricane, because it happened before, of course, Katrina. We had 250,000 people without power here across southeast Louisiana and the New Orleans area. So that's not to say we're going to get that number this time, but give you an idea, there could be widespread power outages with this one.
And you seem to be focused more on wind than rain with this one.
Yeah, rain's not going to be an issue. Again, Sheba, this storm's going to come in and it's going to zip through here. I mean, if you have to get a hurricane, you want them to come in and get out of here quickly. And that's what this one's going to do. Unfortunately, it's going to be a Category 2 when it does that. So we're talking about pretty rough conditions expected out there. And so that's why by, say, 10 o'clock tonight, the rain's coming to an end. So rainfall totals 2, 4, maybe 5 inches of rain in some spots. That would be about it. But again, the wind is number one. Number two concern is the storm surge. And then number three would be the rain.
Dave, the wind shear was supposed to kind of break it up and downgrade it a little bit. It has strengthened. Where'd the wind shear go, and is there any chance that could come back?
The storm's outrunning it now.
Wow.
That's the problem. So you'll see here that with the storm outrunning it, that means here, the storm here again is where it's located, now getting better organized. And then it is going to move over some cooler waters, but again, it's moving so quickly, that's why it's not going to be impacted by it as much. You can see here, though, as we go forward, that the storm, as it moves on into the area, will be kind of working its way across parts of the slightly cooler waters here. I'm trying to show you the wind shear, but the computer's not cooperating. But there we go. You can see what we is the storm here. There's the upper level in El Paso. Here's our wind shear out here just ahead of El Paso. Not here. The storm's going to outrun the wind shear, or when it starts feeling it, already making landfall. So that's why we're looking at a stronger hurricane now.
And it is good that we're expecting it to move fast. Now, when we say move fast, it's not going to sit and dump water for 8 hours. But how many is it going to be hours it's still going to take to get through our area?
I mean, landfall 3-4 o'clock this afternoon. By 10 o'clock tonight, it's already into parts of central Mississippi and Alabama.
Okay.
I mean, so it's going to zip through quickly here. So the rain will be wrapping up by 10 o'clock. So the rain may last longer, but those strongest winds, we're talking in the city, maybe 3-4 o'clock. It starts there and it continues to about, say, 7-8 o'clock. In the evening, so
okay.
About 5-6 hours of time, but that's enough time to cause some problems out there.
All right, Dave.
All right, Dave. Thank you so much for the latest on the storm. We'll get back to you in just a few.